Hey folks, I'm Travis Vigil with Dell Technologies. Welcome to season two of Talking Tech with Travis, where we discuss timely and relevant IT topics, and there could be nothing more timely or relevant than discussing generative AI. Stop talking to me about your widget. Start talking to me about my operating environment and how you bring it all together. I am joined today with a good friend of mine and a very exciting guest, Manuvir, who is the VP of Enterprise Computing for NVIDIA. Manuvir, how are you doing?
I'm doing very well, Travis. I'm excited to be here. It's a fun time, isn't it?
Oh my gosh, it is so exciting what is going on. I mean, there's been a couple of really big announcements recently. Your boss, Jensen, has been in the press talking about it. Jeff Clark from Dell has been talking about it. He actually referred to generative AI as a transformative era with boundless potential. You're right in the middle of it.
Yeah.
How big of a deal is it, Manuvir?
I think it's a huge deal. And can I actually start by saying I agree with Jeff? And yes, we're in the middle of it, Travis, but so are you. Because, you know, the beautiful thing about AI is it's a full stack problem. You need lots of different technologies to bring it all together. Obviously, NVIDIA builds some, Dell builds some, and that's why it's so great to be working with you all, right? So we can bring these technologies together. But I think it is a big deal, you know, and if you ask me, why is it such a big deal? I would say, well, firstly, it's technology that's become really visceral to the end consumer, right? ChatGPT did that. Everybody's played with it, seen what it could do. But also from the point of view of, you know, the customers that you and I deal with, the enterprise companies, right? I think it's such a big deal because previous generations of, you know, previous shifts in computing technology, like the cloud, like virtualization, who did they affect in the company? They affected the tech people in the company, right? The IT teams, the technologists in the company. But I think Gen AI actually affects every employee in the company because no matter what function you're in, Gen AI makes you more productive. If you're in HR, you can figure out what's going on with your employees better. If you're on the IT team, you can understand what's going on with your systems better, right? If you're in sales, you can understand what's going on with your clients better. So I think it reaches everybody.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more, Manuvir. And we are in the middle of this together. You know, we work together on the XE9680 PowerEdge server. It is the fastest ramping product in Dell Infrastructure Solution Group history.
So isn't that amazing?
Great. Thank you for the collaboration on that. And, you know, I agree. Generative AI touches every part of the organization. And in my conversations with folks, especially at the C-suite, there is a discussion around data. And, you know, I think, Manuvir, you were describing, you know, generative AI to me as like, you know, a new college graduate, went to a great school, has all kinds of potential, but they start at the company, they don't know where the bathroom is. You know, they don't know anything about how it works. And to me, getting the right data into generative AI is, the right enterprise data into generative AI is the issue that our customers are struggling with, that are looking for solutions for. You know, I'd love your thoughts on that.
Yeah, I mean, I couldn't agree with you more. And we see it ourselves because, you know, at NVIDIA, we practice AI ourselves quite heavily, right? And we've built a number of things within the company now where we use Gen AI. There's so much information in every company, in your Slack channels, in your Salesforce database, you know, in your ServiceNow installation, information about your products, your interactions with your customers. And it just stands to reason that if you start with an LLM that is not infused with that information, it's like a new employee, right? How would it know? But if you can infuse it, if you can customize it and tune it with all that information, suddenly you've got an employee who's been around for 10 years or 20 years, but hasn't actually lost all the brain cells that they had when they first came out of college, right? So you got the best of everything, right? You got the fresh college grad with all the energy and enthusiasm, but also a lot of knowledge. So I think that's very true. That's what we see with the customers that we work with. You know, Travis, we always start when we have a customer engagement, we say, listen, go take a look at the off-the-shelf stuff. And if that works for your use case, just use it. It's great. But we see a lot of customers who really need to do this kind of customization. and we're working to help them. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm completely aligned with you on that need, Manuvir. I wanted to run something by you. I've been in like no less than a half a dozen generative AI briefings recently. I mean, in the last 2 days, really.
Yeah.
And a common theme I'm hearing is there was this training boom, right? Like all these models are getting trained, obviously, you know, ChatGPT, a lot of training going on in the cloud. Some of the foundational models, whether it be those from Hugging Face or what have you, are also going through this training cycle. But I believe that if we can really take these models, customize them with the data of a specific industry segment or a specific company, turn it into that high potential employee with 20 years of experience within the company, that the inferencing boom is going to be 10x what we're seeing with the training boom. I'm curious to see if you're seeing the same things in your conversation.
Oh, we're absolutely seeing the same thing. And this is why, you know, NVIDIA for years worked on the training technology, you know, and everyone is doing training on GPUs and we built all the software for training. But, you know, in the last few years, we really focused on the software for inference because that's really where the rubber meets the road. You know, and I guess one way of thinking of it is this, right? That if you're a company, you want to ask yourself, okay, how do I go about adopting Gen AI, right? And I would say there's some companies in the world, a small number who say, okay, for my domain, let's say I'm in financial services, right? Or I'm in healthcare. I see myself as this leader that really has access to a lot of data. And I want to go build a foundation model from the ground up for my domain, okay? And then, yeah, you get yourself lots of 9680s and you do a whole bunch of training, right? And you build foundation models from the ground up. Or you're a company where you say to yourself, well, I have a lot of enterprise customers of my own. Like I'm a service now, right? And I reach a lot of different customers with my platform. And now it's not about building one gigantic model, but on the other hand, each of my customers needs a different model. Because I've got a corpus of data for each customer that's different and unique to them. And so now I need a factory because I do a lot of training. Again, the 9680 is an awesome platform, but it's not one giant model that I sit there and train for 6 months, but I've got, you know, a plethora of models. And so the training workload adds up in that way. So you've got some number of companies like that. But then I think for most companies, a great way to go about it is to say, I'll start with the pre-trained foundation model. And then what I'll do is I'll customize for myself. I'll point to my enterprise data. Some of it will be used to fine-tune the model. Some of it will be used at inference time with some information retrieval kind of option. And then I'll embed this model into some app of mine. Typically start with a chatbot, you know, so I can talk to things, information more easily. And that's all inferencing, right? And so what you really need is you need a platform of the hardware and software that is really well geared towards this back end of the process, right? The fine tuning and the inference, not so much the training. And obviously you've got a great PowerEdge platform. We've just talked about that together, right? With this L40 GPU and all the NVIDIA AI.
Yeah, we're very excited about making that announcement with you this week.
Yeah, you know, Travis, if I may. I think another way of laying this out to folks is AI has been hard for people to adopt, right? Enterprise companies to adopt for like the decade we've been working on it. And the reason is because the front end of the process, building a model, is hard because you got to find all this data that's out there. You got to curate it. You got to do all these things to it, label it. And really what LLMs have changed is that if you start with the pre-trained foundation model, all that's already been done. And you're actually starting from the output of that, right? You don't have to go find, you know, a trillion tokens and the right tokens and train them up. You're just starting from the output of that. And then you've got all these data sources already in your enterprise, right? You've got your Salesforce, you've got your Slack, et cetera, and you just point it at those things. And so it makes the process a lot simpler to adopt. And now between you and us, we've got the perfect platform to do it on.
And I'll go back to what you said at the beginning. It is a full stack problem. It's the compute, it's the storage, and that's why the validated designs that we've worked on together, you know, I think are so critical to helping customers have that recipe, have that blueprint on how to build these things out.
That's right. Yeah, we call these workflows. Yeah. We have a whole team of people that, just like you do, you have your solution architects at Dell. We have our folks, and this is what we do. We build these workflows that are basically, as you said, recipes, right? It's like the hello world, but much more, that you can deploy on day one, and then you tweak it from there, right? So you get this head start, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you know, one last question, Manuvir. I have you here. I can't help asking you. I agree. The customers want choice. Customers want flexibilities. Customers want us to help them get these deployments up and running and integrating their enterprise data. Do you see a future world where we have a super pod that is Ethernet based?
Why not? You know, it's an interesting thing, Travis. You know, one of our big missions at NVIDIA really is to democratize AI, right? And that happens in many ways with all the use cases. Obviously, we've got this amazing application with Gen AI, but another important way it happens is making the infrastructure that you need to do this work more accessible, right? And obviously, we've built with InfiniBand, as you know, for these large-scale trainings, and it's very powerful infrastructure. But I think it's a very sensible direction to create the same kind of infrastructure with Ethernet, and we're very happy to work with you on that.
Yeah. Well, I can't wait to get started on that work with you, Manuvir. You know that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for being with me for season two of Talking Tech with Travis Manuvir. We worked together for a long time. This is a lot of fun. We like to say that we're bringing generative AI to our data, not our data to generative AI. And I think the work that we've done together proves that out. Really appreciate having you here today.
Absolutely, Travis. And, you know, if I may, I'll just end by saying the following thing, because I realized I might have confused people, you know, because this compute that we build, when we do this training, it talks to compute and it talks to storage, right? And I think... there's a great opportunity for us on the interaction between the computer and storage, right, which you build with PowerScale to really leverage the power Ethernet, right? And it's something we should go do.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. You said it. That's your old product line, Manuvir.
It was great chatting with you, Travis.
Great chatting with you,
Thanks
too.
For having me.
You're very welcome.
Okay.
Thanks to everybody out there. Thanks for joining me for a very interesting topic, generative AI on Talking Tech with Travis. And we'll catch you next time.